Everybody hates selling. No doubt about it. People cringe at the thought of it. I even heard that people would prefer to go to the dentist than be forced to make a cold call. Doesn't say much about the dental profession. But anyway, if you're interested in being an entrepreneur, selling is going to be a huge part of your life. And if you aren't prepared for that, I think you're going to be in for a little bit of a shock. I want to back that up with a study that a guy by the name of Amar Bide did from Harvard. And his book was called The Origin and Evolution of New Business. And what he did is he studied the Inc. 500 fastest growing companies for a 20-year time span. And one of the things, he came out with all kinds of really cool stuff, but one of the things that I pulled out of that was that the CEOs of the Inc. 500 fastest growing companies over a 20-year time frame, 75% of them said they were the chief or only salesperson in the organization. And so that backs up this claim that, you know, when you go into entrepreneurship, selling is going to be a really important part of that. But why do we think that people despise selling so much? It's because they fear rejection. Who doesn't fear rejection? Everybody does. The myth is that a great salesperson is more comfortable being on a used car sales lot than they are sipping an ice cold iced tea on their porch on a hot August afternoon. They're, well-dressed, slick back hair. They got a joke for everything. They're charismatic. They got some magic superpower that could get you to buy a fur coat on an 80-degree afternoon. That's just not true. And what I want to do is I want to debunk the myth of sales. Sales isn't about your personality. Sales is about building a system and then executing that system over and over, and then improving that system on a very regular basis. Think of it as a machine. The sales mechanism is a machine, and what you do as the entrepreneur is you tweak and you improve and maintain that machine moving forward, and then your primary job is to funnel work to that machine. Let's call it lead generation. Bring leads in, put them in the machine, let the machine do its work, and it will kick out sales. Okay, it's an oversimplification, but why is sales so important? And here's the part that nobody talks about. In the beginning, once you're open, if you have a negative cash flow position, there's really only one place in the world that you can get capital. I mean, other than a rich uncle that's willing to stroke you a check, but you know what? I haven't found too many of those out there. The only place you can get capital is through gross margin. Selling a product and having gross margin left over to help pay your bills and fund the business. And so that's why sales, that's when you hear cash flow is king, that's what we're talking about. And that's why the sales process and being a great salesperson is critical to the business at the beginning, because it's really the only place you've got to get any capital. So I hope maybe this can give you a little bit of confidence around the fact that, you know what, you don't have to have some magical personality in order to be a great salesperson. You've got to build. I'll just give you my system that we use in my business, right? So we're a franchise company. We generate leads through our website. People inquire about becoming a franchisee of Big B Coffee. And so what happens is that lead comes in, and then we do something with that lead. And that lead goes into a machine. And so there's the initial inquiry that leads to the initial response from us. And that's a machine. That's a mechanism. That's a system that it goes into. And then once you have engagement with somebody, then it goes into a different category and then has a different system, right? So once somebody has engaged and you're in a conversation, then they get put into a certain rhythm. There's a structure around it. When we return phone calls, what topics we talk about first, making sure we cover all the topics that we need to cover in order to make the person comfortable with our business. And, you know, to me, sales is not really about selling somebody something. What sales is trying to match up with somebody that appreciates the value of what you offer and they're willing to pay for it. And you know what? If in the end you don't have a product that they value enough to write a check for, well, so be it. Move on and try to find somebody else that does. But I hope I've covered up a bit about the sales process and being a salesperson. And, you know, it's a huge part of being a successful entrepreneur. So wrap your mind around that and get ready, because that's one of the primary ways you're going to generate capital in the business. So for my fellow entrepreneurs out there, keep it simple, keep it clean, stay focused, and go get them. Boom, baby.